Okay, good evening to everyone. Today we see some more examples on the cost sheet. This is the example number 13 collected from Bulgar book. Bahubali Limited gives the following figures for the year ended 31st March 2002. This is the information given in connection with the Bahubali Limited for the year 2001-2002. The year ends on 31st March 2002. Okay, we will see the items one by one. Opening stock of raw material, closing stock of raw material. Opening stock, closing stock, purchase of raw material. These are related with raw material consumed, related with direct material. Opening stock add purchase, then deduct the closing stock of raw material. You will get the raw material consumed. Okay. Then direct wages is here 3 lakh rupee. This direct wage is the second item in the prime cost. Gas and water, it is factory. Direction is there. Gas and water factory goes to factory overhead. Drawing office salary. Drawing office salary is a factory overhead. Drawing office means it is the expense in connection with drawing the design of the product, then the research and development expense. Drawing means drawing the design. Design comes under the research and development. Therefore, the drawing expense is related with factory overhead. This is related with factory overhead. Then rent, rates and insurance factory. It is directly given as factory. Therefore, we take to the factory overhead. Then counting house salary. Counting house salary is the expense related with office and administration. This is a account department expense. Counting house means counting the notes. You have to count the notes. Counting house salary means counting notes, means account department expense goes to office and administration. Then general expense. The general expense is 33,000. They ask to allocate this general expense in between factory and office. Okay. In the office, you have to take 1/3 and factory 2/3. Means out of 33,000, you take 2/3 to the factory overhead and 1/3 to the office and administration overhead. 2/3 of 33,000 means 22,000. That means 22,000 goes to factory overhead and 1/3 means 11,000. 11,000 goes to office and administration. So you have to split this amount into office and factory. Depreciation and repairs to plant. Depreciation and repairs to plant is the factory expense, because plant is always we use in the factory. Okay, plant comes in the factory. Therefore, this is a factory overhead. Direct expense is the part of prime cost. Part of prime cost you have to take in the first head. Then depreciation on office furniture. Office furniture comes in the administrative department. फर्नीचर इज स्पेसिफिकली रिलेटेड विद ऑफिस एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, ऑफिस फर्नीचर, देयरफॉर इट गोज टू ऑफिस एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एक्सपेंस. द नेक्स्ट आइटम इज डायरेक्टर फी, डायरेक्टर इज रिलेटेड विद एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन, देयरफॉर इट इज एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एक्सपेंस. जनरल मैनेजर सैलरी, जनरल मैनेजर इज रिलेटेड विद ऑफिस एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन. वर्क्स मैनेजर सैलरी, वर्क मीन्स प्रोडक्शन, सो इट इज रिलेटिंग टू फैक्ट्री. गैस एंड वाटर इन द ब्रैकेट ऑफिस, दैट मीन्स इट इज ऑफिस एक्सपेंस. रेंट एंड इंश्योरेंस ऑफिस, दिस इज ऑल्सो ऑफिस एक्सपेंस. पावर कॉस्ट, पावर वी यूज इन द फैक्ट्री, देयरफॉर इट इज अ फैक्ट्री ओवरहेड. कैरेज आउटवर्ड मीन्स इट इज अ सेलिंग एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एक्सपेंस. Remember this point very carefully. Carriage inward is related with purchase. Carriage inward is related with purchase. Carriage outward is related with sales. It is a selling and distribution expense. Then salesman salary and commission, it is related with sale. We take in the selling and distribution. Advertisement we make for increasing the sale, so it is selling and distribution expense. Postage, printing and stationery we use in the office. We use these items in the office, therefore it is a office overhead. Then bad debt. Bad debt comes at the time of sales, therefore it is the selling and distribution expense. Sales is the last item. Okay. Like this you have to bifurcate the items related with the prime cost, factory overhead, office and administration overhead, selling and distribution overhead, and last sales. Okay. You know the items related with each head, then draw the cost sheet. Okay. Now we draw the cost sheet. Cost sheet for the year ending 31st March 2002. This is the cost sheet. In this cost sheet, there is no per unit column because units are not given in the problem. Units are not given in the problem. Therefore, it is not possible to calculate cost per unit. So, there is no need of per unit column. First, we take the direct material consumed. Here you take opening stock 2,50,000, add purchase is 5,70,000. If there are purchase expenses you add, I think there is no purchase expense in the problem. Already we have seen the problem. In this problem there is no purchase expenses, therefore you take the total of these two, 8,20,000, then deduct the closing stock of raw material. Closing stock of raw material is 1,20,000. You deduct this, whatever answer comes, that answer is direct material consumed. Direct material consumed is 7 lakh. 7 lakh is the material consumed. Second item, direct labor. Direct labor is 3 lakh. Direct labor is 3 lakh. It may be called by any name. Direct wage, direct labor, productive wage or only wage. Okay. Then third item is direct expense. You take the direct expense. Direct expense in the problem is 10,000. Okay. These three total is called as prime cost. The total of the direct material, direct labor, direct expense is called as prime cost. What is the prime cost? 10,10,000 is the prime cost. 10,10,000 is the prime cost. Then you take the factory overhead. In the factory overhead, whatever I explained already, you take all the items one by one, which are relating with the factory. You take all the expenses related with the factory one by one in the inner column. First item, gas and water. Gas and water is 1,000. Next, drawing office salary, 12,000. Next, rent, rates and insurance, factory, 13,000. Next, depreciation on plant, 22,000. General expense, 22,000. This is two-third part. General expenses totally 33,000. Already explained one. Out of 32,000, 33,000, I have taken two-third. Two-third means 33,000 into 2 by 3. Its answer is 22,000. General expense. Then works manager salary, 60,000. Power cost, 20,000. Okay. These are the items coming under the factory overhead because these expense we incur in the factory premise, production area. So you take the total of this prime cost plus factory overhead is equal to factory cost or work cost or production cost. This is called as factory cost, production cost or work cost. Okay. Next head is office and administrative overhead. Office and administrative overhead. Under this head, you take the expenses connected with the office and administration. Office means general office, means account department, general administration department, and a director's office. Okay. The expense, whatever you incur in the general office and administrative office, you take one by one. First is counting house salary, 37,500. Next is general expense, out of 33,000. General expense is 33,000. Out of 33,000, I will take one-third because they asked to take one-third of total amount. So it is 11,000. 11,000 is taken in the office and administration. 22,000 rupees taken in the factory overhead. Total it is 33,000 as already explained. Okay. Next is depreciation on office furniture. It is 4,500. Next is director fee, 9,000. Okay. Now here there is no space, so I'll go to next page. Here there is no space, therefore I'll go to next page, means next slide. While going to next page, you have to take the total of inner column and total of outer column as balance carry forward. Okay. Balance carry forward. I take the total. The inner column total is 62,000. Outer column total it is 11,60,000. You make the total only when you complete the page. Whenever you want to go to another page. Whenever you complete one page and go to next page, you have to take the total. Otherwise, you don't take the total. Okay, next page. In the next page, I'll take the same total. That is 11,60,000. Then inner column is 62,000. Okay, balance brought forward. Items brought forward. Then remaining items. Next item is general manager salary. It is also related to administration, 75,000. Gas and water related with office. In rent and insurance related with office. Postage, printing and stationery related with office. Okay. These are the items under the office and administration. Okay. Office and administration items. Then you take the total of the inner column to the outer column. Total is 1,48,000. 1,48,000 is the office and administration overhead. then you take the outer column total. Outer column total is 13,08,000. 13,08,000 is the cost of production. Cost of production. Then next is selling and distribution overhead. Selling and distribution overhead. Whatever expense you incur during the course of selling the product and while distributing goods to the ultimate consumer, all the expenses you take under this head. First is carriage outward. Carriage outward, while transporting goods to the ultimate consumer, we incur carriage outward. This is 9,000. The next is salesman salary and commission. This is the selling expense. Advertisement we make for the purpose of boosting up the sales. 5,000. Then bad debt. Whenever you make credit sale, there is a chance of bad debt. 10,000. Okay, the total of these selling and distribution expenses 65,000. You take to the outer column, then take the outer column total. Outer column total is 13,73,000. 13,73,000 rupees called as cost of sale. Cost of sale. Okay. Then you take, you leave one line and take the sales. You leave one line here for writing the profit or loss. Then you take the sales. Sales is 25 lakh. Sale is 25 lakh. So, sale is more than cost. Therefore, there is a profit. There is a profit. What is the profit? The difference between these two. Difference between these two is 11,27,000. 11,27,000 rupees called as profit. Okay. This is the problem which covered maximum items in each head. Okay. Like this, you have to solve the problem.